maximum current is pretty high. It was pretty easy to find solar panels that would not exceed those at current limitations. The other battery types we're thinking of are lithium ion. Some problems with those are they don't function under long periods of discharge, and it could be during the winter where we might run into problems with the batteries going a long time without adequate sunlight to charge them, and so they don't function. The lithium ion boosts a lot of cycles when they go a long time without charging, and they also are very volatile when exposed to water. That, and because our device would be outside for long periods of time with no shelter, it's a big concern. Also, and another battery type is nickel metal hydride batteries. They're much more expensive than the pen what we're looking at, and they also have a higher self-discharge rate. So again, for long-term use, the nickel metal hydride batteries just aren't as suitable for our needs. Our two configurations, we're looking at a series and parallel, and you can look real quick at the two configurations we came up with. We ended up choosing a pseudo combination of two, one in parallel. Parallel will lower our charging voltage so that we can use the higher current solar panels. And also, the lower voltage brings a higher efficiency in our DC-DC converter, which is the ultimate goal, to get as much power efficiently to the device as possible. And with this configuration, our batteries will last 4.42 years. And this is a picture of the finished battery pack and a schematic of the
briefly. Here is the final cost of the second unit that we introduced today, the prototype. Everything up there is exactly that. It's the only one I had one together, and that is the discrete components, all for these switch capacitors. So the final cost is $188. And these are objects.
Let's thank our team. I'll open the floor for questions. Jim, if you would go back to the graphs. Question about why your curves aren't a little bit smoother. Why did I do that a little bit too?
Well, cloud cover. And towards the end of the day, we got a little bit of a shadow from my shoulder.
We can do a test on top of the roof of one of our friends' house. There's an advertisement sign on another building. It starts to block the sound a little prematurely.
Is there a question?
I have a question on the solar cell. You're putting all the solar cells in series, and you made the comment that the current is limited by the worst one in the series, in the chain. What's the expected failure rate of the solar panels, and is putting them in series, is that going to compromise the life of the system?
When they're properly protected from the environment, I don't really know what the rate of decay is, but from what I was reading there, it will last 5 years, so it wasn't an issue in our design.
The issue in the test that limited the current was we had some the panels that were cracked and already damaged before they were even.
The beta version that we were putting up, the one with the picture that we, show here has protected modules that are encased in plastic, and those we bought specifically because the original ones that we had were unprotected. Most of them came cracked or broken during shipping. Some were left out in the lab cracked. Basically, just during assembly, they cracked and limited our current.
And what about the environment in which this whole thing is placed? Is that fairly benign, or is that subject to
standard water and rain, salt spray? Professor Little recommended that, and that's why we had epoxy listed as one of the uses. His plan and our plan was just to spray the entire top of the solar panel with acrylic clear epoxy that would protect it from the water.
So the environment, especially with the salt spray and those kinds of things,
yeah,
means that there's a mechanical configuration to protect the whole system.
Yeah.
Thank you.